Zachariah Jackson, Bassa News. We're here in Elizabeth, New Jersey, talking with Salam Ishmael and James Carey, two Gotham City fighters that continue to fight no matter what. Maybe the Batcave is done, but they continue to struggle, continue to fight here. Salam, I want to start with you. Go ahead.
Well, basically, we're here because, number one, for the last 3 years, we've been addressing this whole issue. For the last 3 years, we've been addressing this issue around what happened in 1741, where three slaves were brought at the side of the county courthouse and burned at the stake to death. The reason being because there's false claims of what the so-called slave revolt or rebellion or whatever they want to call it, claiming that the slave was going to burn down plantations and rape white women and such. Well, there's enough reports that follow that to say that they're not so far from the truth. So we're here at the county. This county and this city have a brutal history of slavery that launches back to the start of this state in 1664 under the leadership of George Carteret, then the first governor, Philip Carteret. We're saying to the county, as they discuss other issues, if they put in place other issues that when other residents make claims on issues where every time we come up, it's something different. As always, sit back, we have to further examine. Even after the fact that all evidence showed that this day did happen. In fact, it happened on February 25th of 1741. So I, along with James and others, part of our 1741 Project Committee, we're gonna be here until there's a monument is placed at the front of the county courthouse, or we'll place one ourselves.
James,
just to piggyback on what Salam said, no other ethnic group historically has been disrespected, such as people of color, African Americans or blacks. If you look at, our Jewish brothers and sisters would not be having this problem if they asked to have a monument and recognizing the Holocaust, it would be up there. As a matter of fact, you go to certain places around Union County, you see them already erected, recognizing the Holocaust. So why is there such a problem when just asking for one thing, to acknowledge it? That's part of reparations, first to acknowledge this dark period in the city of Elizabeth and the county of Essex or Union, whoever was in charge at the time. It was a dark period. You see, Perth Amboy just last year, they didn't recognize that Perth Amboy, that was a thriving slave port. They recognized it. They put a monument up there, recognized. They had a festival there. This county should do the same thing. If you want to be technically speaking, Camden, Perth Amboy, Hoboken, that encompasses Jersey City, in the good old city of Elizabeth, all thriving slave ports. If you don't believe me, look at the late Dr. Clement Price's book. He talks about the historical perspectives in New Jersey.
Okay, well, you know, maybe next week as it warm up and we get closer to the summer, maybe we'll go to some of those places like Perth Amboy in front of their monument and talk to add some strength to the plight here. Again, this is the 1740 Project?
1741.
1741 Project. Okay, again, this is Zachariah Jackson, Bassa News. Good night.